Hi, how are you going? I hope you're feeling as well as possible on your medicines. I'm Pharmacist Fi, and this is Denver. Welcome to our Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Here are my 7 top tips for trying to avoid colchicine side effects when it is taken for gout. Number 1, tell your doctor if you have any kidney or liver problems because they will need to take this into account to advise you how much colchicine to take per dose and how much time to leave between your colchicine doses. Number 2, some people may have kidney or liver problems without realizing it. So if you don't know whether you have kidney or liver problems, ask your doctor about getting blood tests to check your kidney and liver function if you have not already had these recently before starting colchicine, because some people with a kidney or liver problem will need a lower than usual dose of colchicine. Number 3, try to avoid medicine interactions by making sure your doctor and pharmacist know everything you are currently taking and have taken in the last 2 weeks. And when I say everything, I mean every prescribed medicine, every medicine from the supermarket or pharmacy, every herbal product, supplement, or other health product. And ask your doctor or pharmacist to please run a medicine interactions check on their computer for you to find out if anything you are currently taking or have taken in the last 2 weeks may interact with colchicine. And if any interactions are found, immediately ask your doctor whether colchicine is suitable for you or not, and if it is suitable, whether any medicine changes may or may not be needed to help manage the interaction. And remember to avoid eating grapefruit and avoid drinking grapefruit juice while you're taking colchicine. And try to avoid future medicine interactions while you're taking colchicine by asking your pharmacist to please run an interactions check before you start any new medicine or health product. Number 4. Never take more colchicine than the doctor advises to take. And if the doctor's instructions seem unclear or if you forget what the doctor said, ask your doctor to please tell you how much colchicine to take per dose and how many hours or days to leave between colchicine doses. And if there's a particular date that you need to stop taking colchicine. And write these 3 things onto your medicines, allergies, and contacts list. Number 5. I highly recommend that you also ask your doctor or pharmacist to please print or email you the latest medicine information for your brand of colchicine, which will be called a medication guide in the USA or a patient information leaflet in the UK or a CMI or consumer medicine information in Australia. So when you have that medicine information, you can find out even more, like which side effects would need emergency medical attention immediately if they ever happened. And if you forget to take a dose of colchicine and it is almost time for your next dose, don't take the dose you forgot. Just take the next dose when it is due. Number 6. In these 2 quick videos, Denver and I share great ways to try to avoid forgetting to take medicines and to avoid accidentally taking too much of a medicine, which is especially important when we're trying to avoid colchicine toxicity. So I'll put links to these videos into the description section of this video for you. Number 7. If you take colchicine to treat acute gout flares, then this tip is for you. Ask your doctor whether or not you've been prescribed the modern smaller dose schedule for acute gout flare treatment to try to prevent colchicine toxicity side effects like diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, stomach or intestine area pain. And I'll put some info for doctors into the description section of this video, which you are welcome to share with your doctor, so you can ask your doctor whether it may or may not be suitable for you. Some people must not take colchicine due to certain types of health conditions, and some other people either must not take colchicine or need a much lower dose of colchicine because it interacts with a medicine that they're already taking or have taken in the last 2 weeks. So these are some of the key reasons colchicine should only be taken by the person for whom the doctor has prescribed it. Also, because the toxic amount is not a lot higher than the treatment amount of colchicine, it is very important to keep colchicine where children and animals cannot access it. Please note that this video does not cover everything you need to know about colchicine for gout, so I'll put links to my other videos with other really important information about colchicine, plus some videos about gout and other gout medicines into the description section below this video for you. Please click the subscribe and like buttons below this video if you'd like to see more of these medicine safety videos. And also consider supporting us by buying merchandise from our official store on our pharmacistfi.com website. And Denver and I look forward to catching up with you again very soon here on this Pharmacist Fi Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.